Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, song and let me sing forevermore. You all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love.
Look, the moon has landed. Just kidding. We are at the Panmen Scenic Area. This is a Mid-Autumn Festival lantern show. The Mid-Autumn Festival is just around the corner. If you're in a festive mood, hit that like. So let us now take a look at a food fitting for this time of the year.
I bet you a ticket to the moon. You thought I was talking about a moon cake. Well, this is round and bright like the full moon of mid-autumn. But obviously, this is not winter. It is, however, an autumn specialty. It's called foxnut or gorgon fruit among numerous other names. The gorgon plant is mainly cultivated in South and East Asia, with India purportedly accounting for the lion's share. Here in China, nowadays the plant is cultivated in many areas of the country, but the Jiangnan region, especially Suzhou, remains the most famous producer of fox nuts. Present day, thanks to the developed e-commerce industry, the dried nut is not hard to obtain, but the fresh fruit is still pretty rare elsewhere in China. So you'd probably be hard-pressed to find this outside of Asia. But when it's feasible, come and see the real beautiful China and come try the fresh fox nuts. But come in fall, because this is the season for the fruit, and which is why we've been going nuts over fox nuts recently. And for your reference, the British scholar Fraser Dunlop described the fox nut as a kind of chickpea that grows in fresh water. Maybe the texture is what reminded her of chickpea. As you chew on the gorgon fruit, the initial leatheriness quickly gives way to this starchy mouthfeel. Speaking of starch, the use of starch slurry as a sauce thickener has been a common practice in Chinese cooking since eons ago. Nowadays, cornstarch is the go-to choice in upping viscosity, but supposedly, back in the day, according to some sources, the original starch for thickening purpose was that produced from the fox nut, which is why the Chinese compound term for making and using starch slurry is gouqian, with the second character qian referring to qian shi, which is one of the Chinese names for the gorgon fruit. This little ancient Chinese culinary wisdom is similar to how the lotus root starch was used as a dough strengthener when Ming China scholar Zhu Zhi made the first ever bowl of Japanese ramen, as I mentioned in a recent video, linked below. And coincidentally, both the gorgon fruit and lotus root are prized in autumn for their tonic effects. Most notably, the moistening function, which can help alleviate coughs instigated by the drier weather of fall. And also coincidentally, the gorgon plant, also known as prickly water lily, actually looks sort of like the lotus, which is often colloquially referred to as water lily. And not coincidentally, we have a lotus root dish here on the table. Sweet lotus root stuffed with sticky rice. many regional cuisines across China have adopted this dish, which is now pretty much available year-round. But traditionally, this dish is mainly associated with the Jiangnan region and enjoyed as a fall delicacy. Which is why the lotus root slices often come drenched in a syrup containing these yellow flakes from the sweet osmanthus, a quintessentially autumn flower. The red hue is also very typical because the warm color evokes warmth to visually stimulates the body to combat the falling temperature of fog. This redness could be the natural color of some varieties of lotus root, but could also come from brown sugar in the liquid used to simmer the lotus root. Some people replace brown sugar with a combination of rock sugar and red yeast rice. Other recipes might include jujube, also known as red date, which happens to be red, but is added chiefly for its autumn therapeutic benefits. So when you visit China in autumn, remember to try this dish and the fresh golden fruits, because not only do they taste great, they make your body feel great. Wish you all a happy Mid-Autumn Festival. 祝大家中秋节快乐，再见。